two-tone, gold and steel together. People are as divided on two-tone watches as these bracelets are divided in color. Watches that combine steel and gold have been around for nearly 100 years, and in that time have been subjected to the ups and downs of popular fashion. Also during that time, no watch brand has been as successful as Rolex, and no two watches have been as iconic as the Datejust and the Submariner. So it seems fitting to look at these two legends to try to answer the question, two-tone watches, hot or not? This is the Rolex Submariner 116613LB, and this is the Rolex Datejust 41, 126331. Both of these are modern Rolexes made in the last few years, and both are continuations of their respective lines. If you're not familiar with the history of the Datejust or the Submariner, well, this probably isn't the right video for you. But even if you are relatively new to watches, I'll bet you've heard of these timepieces, which speaks to their popularity over many decades. The Submariner is the luxury sports watch. It's often the first big watch purchase many people make, or it used to be when you could get them in a store. And the Datejust is perhaps the ultimate everyday watch. Back when a dive watch was unseemly to wear with a suit, the Datejust was the watch to have, and for those who still prefer that kind of refinement, the Datejust provides it. Rolex refers to their gold and steel watches as Rolosaur. As far as I can tell, that's purely a marketing term. I feel lucky that I get to borrow these watches for this video. Not only are they great timepieces per se, but I think together they show a broad range of what's available in two-tone watches, especially from Rolex. There are differences in types of gold, style of bracelets, the bezels, the dials, and more. Let's start with the gold itself. This Submariner uses 18-karat yellow gold. This Datejust also uses 18-karat gold, but it's a rose gold. Rolex refers to this rose gold as Everrose. This marketing term actually has some benefits behind it. Rose gold is usually made by including copper with yellow gold. That's where it gets its red tint. Apparently, normal rose gold can fade over time as the copper is exposed to the environment. To solve this, Rolex adds platinum to their rose gold, guaranteeing that the color will not fade over the decades. Stylistically, to my eyes, rose gold has a more contemporary look than yellow gold. In the last decade, rose gold has become increasingly popular across all kinds of jewelry, at least according to Wikipedia, which is never wrong. Yellow gold, on the other hand, is the natural color of gold. Depending on your taste, yellow gold is either classic or just old. Maybe one of the reasons rose gold has become so popular lately is that it's darker than yellow gold. Rose gold is not as bright or as flashy as yellow gold. Over the last 40 years, attire has become more casual, and many people want a little less bling on their thing. Rose gold offers that. When I first got into watches, the idea of a two-tone yellow gold watch, and especially the idea of a fully gold watch, seemed in poor taste. Having grown up in the 80s and 90s, watches like these represented the styles of yesterday. And I'm not alone. I think the comical desire for steel watches reflects the taste of people like me. But fashion is cyclical, and gold is legendary.
I love gold!
And however you feel about gold watches, whether two-tone, yellow, or rose, it's hard to argue against the fact that gold is pretty, and Rolex does a great job with it. The bracelets on these watches represent the two most popular styles from Rolex. There's the Oyster bracelet on the Sub, and the Jubilee bracelet on the Datejust. On the Sub, the bracelet is where the gold is most apparent. On the Datejust, I think the fluted bezel draws the most attention to the gold. It's a very attractive bezel. The crisp facets sparkle and shine. The Submariner's bezel is also gold. It has a royal blue ceramic bezel insert with gold numerals. The numerals aren't just gold in color, of course, they're actually filled with gold. The reference of this watch is 116613LB. That LB stands for Lunette Bleue. In English, blue bezel. It's very blue. How much more blue could it be? The answer is none more blue. The same goes for the sub's dial, which is done in a sunray finish. The finish gives the dial depth and pairs really well with the gold markers, gold hands, and gold text. Regarding that text, just a few weeks ago, something interesting happened. Rolex announced the replacement of this watch with the 126613LB. To most normal people, these watches are identical, despite the 1mm increase in size. The hands and markers are the same, but Rolex changed the color of the dial text from this gold color to white. I'm sure there's an argument to be made for that change, but I prefer this gold text. The darker color tones down the text and makes it less apparent that there's a short novel printed on the dial. By contrast, the Datejust dial is relatively simple and clean. Like the Submariner, the Datejust hands, markers, and text match the gold of the rest of the watch. The dial here is also sunray finished, but in this deep brown color. This dial color with the rose gold is just wow. I really like this. It's unusual. Brown is not a common dial color, or at least it hasn't been for 30 years. But looking at this, I can't understand why. This dial reminds me of the older GMT root beers, another two-tone watch from Rolex, whose latest iteration is so popular as to become impossible to get. So, what do we think? Two-tone watches, hot or not? Fully gold watches are still out of reach for most buyers. And now steel watch prices keep creeping up, especially on the gray market. Right now, this Submariner is almost the same price as its steel equivalent, which kind of puts them on equal footing in a buyer's mind. So, which would I rather have? Well, it wasn't long ago that, for me, two-tone watches represented gentlemen of a more mature age. Okay, these were old man watches to me. But more and more, watches like these are attractive to me. The warm tones, the visual contrast, the refinement. I think two-tone watches are about to get hot again. Or maybe I'm just slowly becoming an old man myself. And I think I'll embrace it.